Hey streamers, welcome back to our YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be showing you how you can live stream an event on your WordPress website. So an event can range from a fashion show to a music competition. Whatever you Google to get here, whatever event you have in mind, I can assure you that you can live stream that with the WP stream on your website. So before you do anything else, make sure you install and activate WP Stream on your WordPress website, as that is a plugin for video streaming on your website. Once you've installed and activated it, go to WP Stream credentials, and here you will connect to WP Stream with your email and password. If you don't already have an account, don't worry, you can click over here and it will take you to our homepage, where you can register by clicking Get Started on the top right corner. Add your email, your password, and also confirm your password once again, and register. That's it. It will take you straight to your account on WP Stream, where you'll find your free trial package, and you will start off with 0.5 gigabytes, but you can get an extra 5 gigabytes of streaming data by confirming your email address. So that totals 5.5 gigabytes, enough to test out every single one of our features. So go back, enter your details, and connect to WP Stream. So once you've connected, you're ready to create your first channel. So click on Channels, and you can either create a free channel or a pay-per-view channel. Keep in mind that for a pay-per-view channel, you will be needing WooCommerce for any pay-per-view or subscription events. But for now, I'm just creating a free channel. You can check out one of our other videos to see how you can create a pay-per-view channel. I just added a title. I'm adding an image. You can add any description, tags, categories, and edit your channel the way that you want it to look. So once you're happy with it, just publish it. And here you can start your live event straight away or check out the settings, which I do encourage you to do. So under settings, you can enable the recording button, you can enable or disable viewer count, lock to website, autoplay, start muted, and things like that. I'm going to record this live stream and create a video on demand from it later, so make sure you stay tuned to see how I do that. And I started my live event. So while it's loading, let me run you through Obs Studio, which is a free pro tool that you can use to broadcast live events. And you will need to click on Settings and then on Stream under General. And here you will see that you need to enter a server and stream key. So that is going to be the destination to where you will be streaming to. And you can get that server and stream key by clicking on Go Live with External Broadcaster right over here, and here's your server and stream key. Copy and paste them into the appropriate sections and click on OK. So you've established your destination. Click on Start Streaming. Now to view your live stream, click on View Channel. And here is your live event. You can click on Play. And here it is running. So with the WP Stream player, you can live stream and go picture in picture or full screen. So what you will be needing the picture in picture for, or your viewers actually, with picture in picture, you can move this small screen around the screen, around different tabs, and have your viewers enjoy watching or listening to what you have to say while they're doing other things, or they can just enjoy the full experience by going full screen. And as you can see, it's great quality, and you can add it to your WordPress website, which is always great. There is no censorship, no muting, no random takedowns, and that's the advantage of WP Stream. So I'm done streaming, so I clicked on Stop Streaming on Obs Studio, and this message will appear once I know that the live stream has ended. You can also edit this text by checking out the link down in the description bar. And now, if you remember, I recorded the live stream and I'm going to be creating a video on demand from it. So click on media management in WP stream. And here's the video file. You can delete it, get download link, create a free video on demand or a pay-per-view one. So once again, you do need WooCommerce for the pay-per-view one, but I'm just going to create the free one. You can check out one of our other videos to see how to create a pay-per-view video on demand. Once again, I'm doing the same thing as with the live channel. So I'm adding a title, featured image, tags, categories, and then I'm publishing it. Now, once published, I will click on the permalink over here and it will take me to my video. So here's my video on demand. So the difference between a live stream and video on demand is that with a video on demand, you can go forward, go back, pause, play once again. You can go picture in picture and full screen just like with the live stream, but unlike the live stream, you can't skip forward or go back. You just have to watch in real time. So I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I hope you've learned something new and start live streaming your events on your WordPress website. Don't forget to leave a like, comment what you want to see next, and subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to hit that notification bell. Thank you so much for watching, and hope to see you soon with another video. Bye!